Hello everybody, welcome back to the e-learning space for MGM Higher Secondary School, Bokaro. In this video lesson, we are going to discuss about speech writing. What is speech writing? You must have often seen leaders, orators, and debaters going up on stage, standing in front of a podium, holding a mic and speaking on a topic which often moves the audience. This speech or the topic that he speaks on has to have the power to influence the audience in front. So what are the main contents that a speech must have so that it meets the purpose? What is the purpose? To get your ideas across masses or the audience present. In order to write a speech, you must very well know what you're going to talk about. So the ideas should be clear in your head. What is a speech? A speech is a formal talk that a person delivers to his audience. It must have the capacity to hold the attention of the audience with a proper choice of words, expressions, and examples. At the same time, care should be taken not to deviate from the main subject. You must keep in mind that it is a speech and you need to begin the draft with addressing the audience. And conclusion should be with a sentence thanking the audience. So students, you must prepare the topic beforehand. You must know the common or the contemporary ideas related to the topic, the popular sayings that can go with the topic. And remember, because you're addressing an audience, you must greet them. And because you're concluding your ideas in front of an audience, once again, you must thank them. So, as much as the content of the speech is important, it is also important that you do not give unnecessary details or unnecessary arguments or discussion in a speech. Stick to the topic. Your words should be good. Your expressions must be excellent. And the examples that you will draw in order to make the audience understand the topic better should be well researched. If you are giving some statistics, those should also be well researched. Remember, when you write a speech, please make sure your ideas are in a sequence. Let it not be haphazard or unnecessary details must be avoided. Now, I am going to share in this video some tips for good speech writing. Always remember who you are writing the speech for. Who is your audience? What your speech is going to be about and the main points in order of importance. If you have, suppose, 12 points in your mind, choose the most important one first and then go on with the decreasing order of importance. And maybe if there is a word limit or time limit and you cannot fit all the points, try to ignore the ones which are less important ones. Always try to make sure that your speech has small sentences so that it is effectively delivered to the audience. Preferably, if a sentence has not more than 10 to 12 words, it would be good enough to deliver it to the audience. Too circumlocutory or too grandiloquent words or too huge sentences often try to get the audience confusing. It is better to avoid the audience from getting confused because a good speech is clear, a good speech is comprehensive, and a good speech has the power to reach many. Now, here are some value points that are going to help you deliver a good speech, or write a good speech. Always greet your audience and introduce the topic you're speaking on. Let there be no confusion of what you're going to speak on. The introduction part of the speech, remember, is the most important part. So let it be very effective. It is the part which decides the impact of the speech. Do not give a separate title for the speech. Often you will come across some people who say that the speech should have a different title, but this is not necessary and often it is avoided. But keep in mind the occasion of the speech and the nature of the audience, because this is going to decide the tone. On what occasion and on what kind of people or for what kind of people you're going to write the speech. Keep that tone in mind, and hence that will determine the language of your speech. And whenever you're introducing yourself or the topic, do not be very lengthy. Nobody wants to have a very lengthy introduction to a certain topic or yourself. The main topic should be taken up as quickly as possible. Do not create a maze of words around the topic. Let it be simple, clear, and reach the main topic as soon as possible without making it too long. Always use concrete terms and tangible examples. Concrete terms, tangible examples. These are very effective in making your speech a good speech. Now, avoid abstract phrases which are quite vague. Vague, something that is not clear to the audience, please do not use them. Always use simple and familiar language. Like I told earlier, if possible, use smaller or shorter sentences of not more than 10 to 12 words. And the language should be familiar. Do not make it circumlocutory or do not make it grandiloquent. The conclusion plays a very important role in the success of a speech. What is the conclusion? Conclusion, after you deliver your speech on the main topic, after you have laid down your examples and your ideas, what you think. Just summarize them in a conclusion and make sure you do not leave your speech unsummarized. Give it a proper ending, a conclusive ending. And always make sure that the conclusion has your own ideas. It's a little bit subjective in nature. What you have learned after your research on the topic, or what you have learned after delivering this speech on this topic, what are your conclusions? And the marking scheme for speech writing is similar to that of article writing. I should share with you that as well. And because you're ending your speech, because you're spoken in front of an audience, or you've written the speech for an audience, remember to thank the audience for being patient and listening to you or reading out your speech. In an examination, remember, you are writing a speech in order to earn marks. So writing the speech has a purpose here, the purpose of earning good marks. So when you are writing a speech, you are writing to inform people according to the topic. Maybe you're persuading them for something, you're convincing them, or maybe just entertaining them. So make your purpose just before writing the speech, when you read the topic of the question, make your purpose very clear. Why you are writing this speech? Are you writing it to entertain people, to inform people, to persuade, to convince them? And because when the purpose will be clear to you, then the choice of the word, the style, the vocabulary, the clarity, all this will come to you. And then you can frame your sentences in a better manner, because now your sentences will be driven towards a purpose. Generally, here is the marking distribution for speech writing. One mark is always for the format, the opening address, that is the introduction, and the conclusion. The middle part is the most important because it contains the content. It decides whether your speech is good, what kind of vocabulary you are using, what kind of grammar you are using, and how influencing is your speech. This contains 4 marks generally in an exam as per CBSE. And of course, because it is a writing section, your grammar has to be accurate. Your spellings and words have to be appropriate. Now, coherence and relevance of ideas and style means how well you have blended your ideas and how well one idea progresses from the previous idea. This is called coherence. Means the speech should not look like there is no head and tail. Everything should be properly arranged. These two categories again contain 2.5 and 2.5 marks respectively, and together they make 10 marks in total. This is the CBSE marking scheme for speech writing. Now, what is the format? Like I said, there has to be an introduction, the body part has the content, and then there's the conclusion part along with the thanking the audience. Now, in order to write a perfect speech, we must be well acquainted with the topic and must possess a wide range of vocabulary, a thorough knowledge of the subject, some research, and excellent organizational skills. Here are the ideal format and tips to help you write your perfect speech. So you have to have a good vocabulary so that you can choose from a wide range of words. And whatever the topic be, make sure you have good knowledge of that topic in order to write something on it. And remember to organize or arrange your ideas in a proper way. Now, heading. Like I said, you can give a heading to your speech. You may not give a heading to your speech. But if you decide to give a heading or a title to your speech, do not make it lengthy. It should be catchy, it should be interesting, and not more than 5 to 6 words. But just because thinking of a heading and being creative, do not waste time in thinking about a creative heading and wasting your time. Okay? Opening line. In these opening lines, salutations means you have to greet the audience, your introduction should be there, and you have to mention what topic you're going to speak on. This is important because the audience should have a clarity who you are and what you're going to speak on. But in the exams, children, please remember, do not mention your own name, do not mention your school name, because generally in the question, it's clearly given who you have to write the speech as, or what post do you hold and what you have to write on, who you are. These details are already given in the question and you must use those details in your speech writing. For example, when you begin, respected principal, teachers and my dear friends, today the name will be given in the question, stand before you all to speak on the topic, and then the question will have the topic, you can insert the topic there. Remember, it is advisable and appreciated if you begin with a quote. It is a general style, an acceptable style, and even, you know, applauded style when people begin with a quote. And this quote cannot be any random quote that you just remembered during the exam. No, try to relate your quotes to the topic. For example, if I'm writing a speech on something about world peace, and love and brotherhood and fraternity. So it would be good for me to begin with a speech that or quote, to begin my speech with a quote that talks about the importance of love, or a famous quote of a very famous personality that has given the idea of peace or love and how important it is for the wholesome working of the entire universe. So once you introduce your topic with the help of a quote, then you may go for the salutation, then the introduction of yourself and the topic that you're going to speak on. This is a very good idea to write a speech. In the body, as we know, it is going to be the main part of your writing piece. So always begin with short introduction on the topic. It must be precise, like I told you, not very long, not very lengthy. Few words are enough to introduce the topic. Then explain the current situation. If the topic contains something that has the scope to talk about the current problems, and if there are something that tells you that corrective actions are needed, situation can be made better, then you can throw a little light on that as well. If the topic is such that may have advantages and disadvantages, please mention those as well. talk about both the things in your speech because it is not a debate. Now, always remember your ideas must have a proper sequence. Sometimes it is possible that we have many ideas. Like I said before in this video, we might have many ideas. So arrange your ideas in decreasing order of importance and take the most important ones, introduce them in your speech, write them in your speech, deal with them in your speech. But if you do not have enough space, enough time, leave out the less important ones. Because you're writing a speech during an exam, you will of course have word limit and time limit. So do not exceed your time limit, do not go wayward, do not deviate from the topic. And it is always advisable to begin with your strongest point. Do not think that you will accommodate the strong point at the end. No, that would be an error. That would be a wrong thing to do because people who are reading your speech, they want to see something strong in the beginning. And because it is a speech on a topic that you are writing, please remember it is advisable to use your personal opinion. And it is quite possible that while giving your personal opinions and while relating to the facts, you might get deviated by relating one topic to another, but refrain or stop doing that or avoid doing that. And after this introduction, after the salutation, after introducing your topic, when you write the content, when you write the main part, the body, keep it concise, keep it all the strong points in one place. And then when you conclude or give the solution, if the topic is related to something that is looking for a solution, give the solution. If the topic is only needing a conclusion, your ideas have to be incorporated. It's like picking some of the points from the entire body and giving a conclusion, okay? Improvise, change your words, do not be repetitive, do not sound repetitive, but yes, improvise and then make a few suggestions, few solutions, and then give your concluding paragraph. If you're adding quotes, like I said, you begin with a quote, and even in the middle, you can, you know, use some proverbs, some idioms, and some great quotes just to relate to your idea, just to make it more appealing to the audience. And often strong point, weak point, strong point. This idea is a good idea to present a speech. Now, lastly, when you're concluding your speech, when you're giving your concluding paragraph, please remember to thank the audience who sat there or who were present there to listen to you or to read out your speech. So it is always conclude what you have started and thank, because you have given salutation to the audience in the beginning. So it is just logical to thank them at the end. And it's not something that you have to leave open-ended. Means not leave the people wondering what happened. Always be conclusive. Let it be a rounded speech. Begin with a quote, end with a similar statement, or conclude according to the topic or according to the body or the content that you have created in the speech. Let us now discuss a little more about speech writing, some tips that never go wrong. First of all, make sure your language that you're using is suitable for the audience that you're going to address. Do not use very complex vocabulary if your audience contains children. So depending on your audience, make the choice of your vocabulary. And I am stressing on the point, use quotes. It's a very recommended point. Use quotes. That is why read quotes beforehand from great leaders on various random topics, so that during the exam you have something, you know, substantial to write. You can use quotes in the beginning of the speech, you can use them at the end of your speech, you can even use idioms, proverbs, and other quotes in the middle, in the body of the speech. And make sure you write in paragraphs and you have a neat work to present before the people. And if possible, please prepare the previous year question papers. There are various question papers and material available from CBSE in order to help you practice these things. It's a very good idea to read as many samples as possible. This is true for both all the writing sections, all the comprehension sections. Read as many samples as possible because it will give you an idea how a speech should be actually written. And to develop the practice of writing, develop the practice of reading as well. Read the editorials, the opinions that come in the newspaper, because it helps you to give opinions. When you already have been following such editorials and opinions, it makes it easier for you how to present new ideas and opinions while writing. And always do not just start writing. First plan it in your mind which points you're going to put first, followed by which points, because it is always advisable to keep your work neat. So if you have a flowchart, a plan beforehand, your work will be neat, your ideas will be coherent, and it will look good. Your speech will actually look wholesome. Decide the sequence beforehand how you're going to develop your ideas. Presentation is very important. When you are taking your speech to the stage, make sure your presentation is good. Double check for grammatical accuracies and spellings. Do not, I repeat, use wrong grammar or wrong spellings, because like I said, they carry marks. And leave adequate number of lines between paragraphs so that your work looks neat. If you want, you may even underline the main points which you think are important. Use a pencil for underlining if needed. Have some quotes handy, like I said, because when you're presenting your speech, these quotes add material to your speech. Now that brings us to everything that I could share on speech writing with you. These tips, follow them and you will never have a wobbly speech, or I will say a substandard speech. Now here is an assignment for you to practice. As Mukul or Mahima of ALPS Public School, write a speech to be delivered in school assembly, highlighting the importance of cleanliness, suggesting that the state of cleanliness reflects the character of its citizens. The word limit would be 150 to 200 words. A very easy topic, a very contemporary topic as well. You can relate it to the current political system, which talks about clean India, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, begin with a nice quote on cleanliness. You can go on relating the ideas of how, you know, cleanliness is helping people stay healthy in body and mind, everything. There's so many ideas. Remember, you're making the speech in front of your school friends in an assembly. So which audience will you be greeting? How will you be introducing yourself? How will you introduce the topic? Then continue with the topic and conclude it in your own words. Thank you, everyone. That brings us to the end of our video lesson on speech writing. Do the assignment, and if we have any confusion, we are going to discuss it in our online classes. Take care till then. Thank you.